Insulin resistance increases your risk of being overweight, having high triglycerides or high cholesterol, having high blood pressure, and developing major depression disorders. You can be insulin resistant for years without knowing because doctors don't typically test for insulin resistance. The condition does not trigger any noticeable symptoms. The only thing is that if you're insulin resistant, you will have trouble losing weight. Insulin resistance causes diabetes. Some of the classic symptoms are extreme thirst or hunger, feeling hungry even after a meal, increased or frequent urination, tingling sensations in your hands and feet, feeling more tired than usual, frequent infections, and evidence of high blood sugar levels in your blood work. Some people with insulin resistance may also develop a skin condition. It appears as dark, velvety patches, often on the back of the neck, groin, and armpits. If you don't have obvious symptoms, your doctor can usually detect prediabetes or diabetes with a hemoglobin A1C test, also known as the HbA1c test. You may want to consider testing if you've noticed any of the symptoms I've already mentioned, as well as if you have a sedentary or inactive lifestyle, if you have a low HDL or good cholesterol level, if you have a high triglyceride or bad cholesterol level, if your waist circumference is more than half your height. I have spelled out how to measure belly fat to know if you're at risk of certain health conditions in one of my videos, How to Measure Belly Fat. It is also said that if you have a parent or sibling with type 2 diabetes, you may want to have a check because the possibility that you may also be living with type 2 diabetes or are insulin resistant may be high. I do explain my analogy for why I think this assumption is the case in my video, Why I Ignore the Diabetes Guidelines. Three easy ways to reverse type 2 diabetes mellitus. So do well to check it out after this video if you haven't yet. Another reason you should consider testing your A1C is if you have high blood pressure, 140, 90, or above. If you have symptoms of prediabetes and have been diagnosed with gestational diabetes before, gestational diabetes is a temporary condition that causes diabetes only during pregnancy. I explain why it is imperative to take gestational diabetes seriously in my video, Why I Ignore the Diabetes Guidelines. If you were diagnosed with gestational diabetes during pregnancy, do well to take the A1C test so that you can start taking actions towards reversing type 2 diabetes as soon as possible. Research indicates that if you have had a baby who weighed more than 9 pounds, your risk factor for insulin resistance increases considerably. If you have also previously experienced a stroke, you may want to consider testing your A1C or HbA1c. Prevent insulin resistance by moving more. Avoid snacking altogether in between meals. Avoid late night eating and consume low glycemic index foods. I explain into detail how I incorporated healthy habits into my diet in my video, How I Reversed Type 2 Diabetes in 2023. Reducing your body weight by just 7% can help lower your risk of developing diabetes. Making health-promoting lifestyle choices is the best way to help get your blood glucose levels in the desired range. Choose whole and processed foods and reduce the consumption of highly processed foods. Highly processed foods such as white bread, rice, pasta, soda, digest very quickly and can spike blood sugar levels considerably. This puts extra stress on the pancreas because the pancreas has to make more insulin to accommodate and regulate, as well as help decrease the spike in your blood sugar levels. The more you consume processed carbohydrates, the more your insulin stays high. The more your insulin stays high, the more your body blocks the insulin from working correctly to lower blood sugar levels, hence becoming insulin resistant. Saturated fats have also been associated with insulin resistance. Incorporate and eat high fiber meals and mixed meals. Your carbohydrate, protein, fat, vitamins, and other nutrients should be in balanced proportions. This will help slow digestion and take pressure off the pancreas. I hope this information has been helpful. If it has, do me a favor and like this video. Watch other videos for more tips. Until next time, remember to be beautiful, be bold, be true to yourself and to others. Stay healthy and always be you.